everyone, welcome to The Explorer. I'm Miss Jane.
I'm Quan Pang.
Today we will look at reading comprehension. The title is The Farmer and His Sons. Please print out this paper and get ready because we are going to use this paper later on. And then take out your vocabulary book. So now, please get ready with this paper and I will read the passage. You have to pay attention and you listen to my explanation. So, let's start. First paragraph. A farmer has three grown-up sons. They always quarrel among themselves. They are advised by their father to live in peace, but it has no effect on them. He is worried about their future. So, 这一段呢, 是在讲什么? 就是讲这个农夫呢, 他有三个成长的儿子, 那他们呢, 是时常吵架。 所以呢, 他们就被他的爸爸劝告, okay, you see this passage is the okay, passive form are advised by. So 被他爸爸劝告呢, 就讲一定要和睦相处, but it had no effect on them. 可是呢, 还是没有效果。 所以他就很担心他们的未来, okay, worry about their future. So next paragraph. One day, the farmer falls seriously ill. His sons are summoned to his bedside. Then, they are asked to collect a handful of sticks, which they do at once. The sticks are tied into a bundle. So, 就有一天呢, 这个农夫就病倒了, 就是很严重的生病, 所以他就 他的儿子们呢就被他吩咐来到他的床边 then 他就叫他们儿子做什么呢 就是去收集一捆的树枝 然后他们就立刻去做了 then 他们就把这个树枝呢绑成一捆 into a bundle 就是一捆一捆 then next paragraph then the three sons are asked to break the bundle one by one. They try hard to break the bundle, but none can do it. Later, the bundle is untied by the farmer, and his sons are asked to break each stick. They do so quite easily. 然后呢, 这三个儿子呢, 就被吩咐去弄断这一捆, okay? 他们就已经绑成一捆一捆, 所以他们就被吩咐去弄, 把这个一捆一捆的树枝呢, 就弄断它。 那他们就试了很多次, 可是还是没有办法做到。 Later, 这个一捆的那个树枝呢, 就他的, 爸爸就是那个农夫, 去弄散了, okay? Untie, 就是他去弄散, 拿出来一只一只 然后就给他的儿子 就是去弄断它 因为已经拆散出来了 那他们就去弄断的时候呢 就觉得讲是很容易的 They do so quite easily okay? 就是很容易的去折断这些树枝 那 next we look at the fourth paragraph Their father said My dear son You cannot break the sticks as long as they are tied together. But you can break each single stick quite easily. They are strong in bundle, but become weak when they are separated from one another. So, never forget that united we stand and divided we fall. 那他爸爸就告诉他的儿子们呢,就说,我亲爱的儿子们, 你如果是把这些树枝呢都绑成一捆的时候呢, 你是很难给你也不能够去弄断它。 可是呢, 如果你是拆散一只一只的树枝去折断它呢, 其实是很容易。 那为什么呢？ OK， 就是因为他讲，如果呢他是绑成一捆的时候，他的力量是很强的， OK， 很大的力量。可是呢，如果你是拆散，就是一只一只的话呢，他的力量就是很弱了。所以他这个是要告诉他的三个儿子呢，团结就是力量。Alright, united we stand and divided we fall， 就是团结就是力量。So last paragraph, this has a deep effect on the farmer's son. They give up quarreling and begin to live in peace. 然后呢，这个事情呢，就会深深的影响到这三个儿子。那他们也决定。Okay, they give up, 就是他们放弃了。They give up quarreling, 他们也放弃了去吵架。And begin to live in peace, 就决定要和睦相处，就是要和平的一起生活。Alright, so this is the passage about the farmer and his son. So now, I will read one more time. Okay, get ready. A farmer has three grown-up sons.They always quarrel among themselves. They are advised by their father to live in peace, but it has no effect on them. He is worried about their future. One day, the farmer falls seriously ill. His sons are summoned to his bedside. Then they are asked to collect a handful of sticks.Which they do at once. The sticks are tied into a bundle. Then, the three sons are asked to break the bundle one by one. They try hard to break the bundle, but none can do it. Later, the bundle is untied by the farmer, and his sons are asked to break each stick. They do so quite easily.Their father said, My dear son, you cannot break the sticks as long as they are tied together, but you can break each stick, single stick, quite easily. They are strong in bundle, but become weak when they are separated from one another. So, never forget that.United we stand and divided we fall. This has a deep effect on the farmer's sons. They give up quarreling and begin to live in peace. So I want you to underline all these words with your red pen. Okay, so look at the first one. Quarrel, are advised, are summoned.Handful of sticks are tied, is untied, are separated, united we stand and divided we fall, effect, and also give up. Okay, so make sure you underline all these words.
Alright, take out your vocabulary book and write these words and sentences into your vocabulary book. Number one, quarrel.吵架 quarrel write the word quarrel read and at the same time write the meaning in Chinese sentence A they always quarrel among themselves they always quarrel among themselves this sentence is simple present tense showing habitual action 他们时常互相吵相骂Okay, this is quarrel word. Okay, so write the sentence A. And you don't have to leave a line. 不要空行啊。Write B. B sentence. Mr. Lee 昨天和他的邻居相骂。Mr. Lee 昨天和他的邻居Now, I have given you the sentence. What you need to do is you're going to choose the correct verb. Okay, 昨天相骂 Which word, okay, which verb should you use? Quarrel, quarrels, or quarrel? Okay, so check on your own. You're talking about past actions. Past tense past action, so use a past tense verb. So which is the past tense verb? So please write that verb. Just copy that verb. Okay, you don't have to copy the rest of the words. Okay, one more time. Mr. Lee 昨天和他的邻居相骂. Okay, so that's B sentence. Okay, you can pause first, 停一下, copy all the sentences first before you move on to number two. Number two, are advised, 被劝告, advice is 劝告, so are advised means 被劝告. And the sentence A, they are advised by their father to live in peace, but it has no effect on them. Okay, so we have read the story. They are advised, means the three sons are advised, 被他爸爸劝告, to live in peace, 要好好的相处, okay, but it has no effect on them, 就是没有什么, 对他们没有什么, effect, okay? Your sentence A. Write the sentence first, okay, and then you check. Are advice means pay. So is MR with a past participle, it means pay. Sentence B, a very simple sentence. I want you to write about the students, subject the students, 那些学生, 被他老师劝告. Okay, so the students is or am or are, so you have to use either one. Okay, is or am or are, students 很多. Okay, 多多 are, see are advised, 被劝告, 被谁, by who, by their teacher, to do what, to study hard. Okay, so a simple sentence. Subject, 那些学生, okay, you have to write 被劝告. Okay, by who? 被谁劝告? By their teacher. To study hard. So that's for sentence B. Leave a line number three. Are summoned. Are summoned means 被吩咐. 被吩咐. 被叫的意思. Okay? So write are and summoned. So always remember is MR. 在前面, 后面是 past participle. 它就是被了. Sentence A. His sons are summoned to his bedside. His sons, 他的孩子, 被吩咐, 就是被叫, 去哪里? To his bedside, 去他的床的旁边那边, right? 因为他已经生病的, right? 很严重了, 所以他不能起来, 所以他的孩子, 被吩咐, 被叫, 去他的床旁边, 床边, it's called bedside. Okay, so write the sentence A. His sons are summoned to his bed. Sentence B, don't leave lines. Okay, 不要空行, write your B sentence. Talk about Sam. So Sam, subject, verb, please choose is, am or are. So which one? So his sons, just now sentence A, his sons. 他的孩子, 三个孩子, so are, 多多 are. What about Sam? Sentence B, Sam, I am, you are, we are, they are, 多多 are, he is, Sam, he, so, okay, choose one, is or am or are. Summon, 被吩咐, to where, 被吩咐, 被叫去哪里, to the headmaster's office, 被叫去校长的办公室, okay? So write your sentence, Sam subject, so choose one, is or am or are, then only you write summon, to where? To his 校长的 office. Okay, so write that sentence on your own. Next sentence, 4. Number 4, handful of sticks. Handful 是一把. Sticks 树枝, okay, or 木棍, okay, or 木柴, we call sticks. Handful 一把的木柴, okay, handful of sticks. And the sentence then, they are us. 他们被叫, okay, 被他爸爸叫做什么? To collect a handful of sticks. 他们被叫去收集一把的木柴木棍, okay, so that which they do at once means 立刻的他们就去做了. Alright, so your sentence A, then they are asked to collect a handful of sticks which they do at once. So that's for 4A. They are asked, 他们被叫. Okay, how do you know? Because SMR with a past participle 就是被了. Okay, so write your 4A sentence. Then 4B, talk about Cinderella, 灰姑娘. Okay, 灰姑娘 is or am or are. Asked, 被叫, 被谁叫? 被她的 stepmother, stepmother 是后母. Okay, 被她的后母叫做什么? 收集一把的木柴, okay, or 木树枝. Right, so how to write Cinderella? Okay, choose is or am or are. Choose one only, remember. Okay, asked to, 收集 is collect. Collect what? Collect a handful of sticks. By who? By her stepmother. Okay, so please write this sentence on your own. Leave a line number 5. Tie. 背绑. Tie. Tie 是绑. So when you are, with R in front, 它是背. 背绑. Sentence, the sticks are tied into a bundle. The sticks, 那些木棍, 背绑成一捆. Okay, bundle 就是一捆. Right, so this is your sentence for A. So you write this sentence into your exercise book. Okay, again, I need to remind you, please don't leave lines. Sentence B, I want you to talk about the books. So subject, 那些书, 背绑成一捆. So that's very simple, you write on your own. The books, is or am or are. Total are, see, 被绑成一捆, so are tied into a bundle and put into a bag. See, 被绑成一捆, 然后就被放进一个 bag. Right? One more time. 那些书 subject, then the books. 被绑成一捆, are, take a look at sentence A, they can write, are tied into a bundle and put into a bag. That's sentence number 5B. Okay, you can pause. 停一下, write all your sentences first before you move on to number 6. Sentence number 6 is untied. Untied is the opposite of tied. Tied 是绑刚才. Untied 就是松开. Right, when you have is in front, if there's a verb to be is in front, is untied 就是被松开. Is untied. Sentence A, later, the bundle is untied by the farmer and his sons are asked to break each stick. Later, 然后, the bundle refers to 那一捆的木棍, okay, or 木柴, is untied, 被松开. By the farmer, 被那个 farmer 松开了, and 他的孩子呢, 就被叫, are asked, 就是被, okay, are asked to break 断, each stick. Right, so this is sentence A. Read the sentence as you write, as you copy it into your exercise book. Sentence B, I want you to write a very simple sentence, talk about the parcel. Okay, 那个包裹被那个 postman 送开了。See, so the parcel is or am or are, one parcel only. Okay, like just now, a bundle, the bundle, one bundle only, 一个包裹罢了。Okay, so this is the parcel. So the parcel 一个包裹 so is untied. Okay, 被送开 by who?By the postman. Okay, so please write your B sentence now. Legal line number 7. Are separated. Separated means 分开. So are separated is a 被分开. So is MR 在前面一个 past participle verb 就是被. Okay, sentence A. They are strong in bundle but become weakWhen they are separated from one another. They, subject, so they refers to the pile of sticks. Okay, so the sticks, 那些木材木棍, they are strong, 他们很强的。如果是 in bundle, 如果是在一捆的时候他们是很强。But become weak, 但是会变很弱。When they are separated, 他们被分开。Okay, 就讲一只一只的时候，他们是很弱的，就很容易咬断了，对吗？所以如果但是全部一捆的时候，他们就比较难咬断了。Alright, so that's for sentence A. Are separated. Sentence B. Talk about the egg white.And the egg yolk, 就是蛋白跟蛋黄被分开了。Okay, so 那个蛋白跟蛋黄 the egg yolk 被分开。So the egg white subject, then your verb is or am or are separated from the egg yolk. See, so you have to think of is or am or are. Egg white.Singular subject, so use the singular verb is. 不可以用 are 了，因为它是不能算的。Okay, so the egg white is separated from the egg yolk. Leave a line number 8. United we stand and divided we fall. Okay, so 这个是一个谚语来的 ，right? 就是团结就是力量。Okay, the meaning, united, we stand, and divided, we fall. Sentence A, so never forget that united we stand, and divided we fall. This is A sentence. Okay, the writer said, don't forget, never forget, 不要忘记, 团结就是力量。Okay, so sentence B. Okay, read the sentence. The soldiers. Subject. Is or am or are told to stay together when the enemy comes. Enemy 是敌人。So 如果敌人来了，那些兵士被叫。Okay, so bay is or am or are soldiers, many soldiers, 多多 are told, so 被告诉或者被叫 to stay together, 就是要集合要团结在一起 when the enemy comes, 当敌人来了 Okay, and then after that, you continue with the quote here, okay, that isUnited we stand and divided we fall. Okay, so 继续的再写下去，就讲团结就是力量。所以说那些兵士一定要团结的。Alright, so must stay together. So are told, 被告诉。So which one? So you write one answer only, is or am or are, and told. Right, so that's for sentence number 8. Leave a line number 9. Effect, 影响, or 效果. Sentence, this has a deep effect on the farmer's sons. This refers to the story. Okay, 那个故事讲, 他叫他的孩子来咬断了那一捆的木. Okay, 那个树枝跟 拿分开他们一只一只的时候，把它拿来咬断。 所以这个故事呢， 给了那些孩子一个很深的印象。 So has a deep effect， right? 很深的一个印象， right? On the farmer's sons. Okay, copy the sentence first, and then you will write sentence B. Sentence B, this medicine has a fast effect. 这个药有一个很快的效果。 Okay, so here you say 效果。 Alright, so when you write, this medicine has a fast effect on who? On me. Okay, so 讲给我。 这一个药呢有一个很快的效果。 That's the meaning of the sentence, right? So you say on me. Sentence number 9. The last sentence, give up. Okay, we say give up means 放弃. Sentence, they give up quarreling and begin to live in peace. They give up, 他们放弃吵架了, 就是不再吵架了, right? And begin to live in peace. 就一起的好好的生活. So write the sentence first. They give up quarreling and begin to live in peace. Sentence B. Subject. 那些参赛者. Okay, so you write the subject. 那些参赛者. 被劝告, 不要放弃. 这一首被, so when you use 被劝告, so you need to have is or am or are in front of the verb advised. So you think and see, subject, the participants, 很多的参赛者, so is or am or are, the right answer, then advised not to give up. 被, so is, am or are, 被然后劝告, advised, 不要 give up. Okay, so that's for sentence number 10. Homework to be sent this week is the recording of your passage. Okay, so please read the passage a few times, then record your reading. 其实真的不用拍给我了，我只是要听你读罢了。 Okay, so 这个星期是要流利地读这个篇故事, The Farmer and His Sons. Okay, and then after that, record and send to me.
That's all for today's lesson. Thank you. Subscribe to Explorer for more lessons. Have a nice day.